be putting a wall around this. Just because I get so tired of losing all the resin when I tilt it. So let's put the wall. I'm not gonna leave it on there for a long time. I'm just gonna leave it on there just for about 2 hours. And then take it off, and hopefully it'll still kind of run, but it'll be like a real thick, gnarly drip to where it would be kind of artsy, I guess. I don't know. We'll see. I haven't done this yet, so. This will be an experiment. I think if you pinch these corners, it'll kind of make it a little bit more rigid, stand up a little bit more. This should be fun. Try to get it nice and sealed around it. Is that even in the shot? I couldn't tell. All right. Today we're going to go bright and happy.
Spring.
Very cotton candy-y. We're going with some fine, very fine kind of glitter that sticks to you for like a week. Pink. We're gonna go with some Bombay magenta. I don't know if you guys can see it. We're gonna go with some dragon fruit. There you go. Okay. Some white. This stuff does really well. And we haven't used Mehron in a minute. There we go. We're going to use some of that. And I'm going to try to do pour with the countertop epoxy. I think we've just done a... We did do that. We used that on the winning piece that Hanging with Tony won. And I want to thank Hanging with Tony for sending us some new subscribers, possibly some customers that might want to buy some artwork from us. Thanks, Tony. All right, let's see here. I have these marked off equally. I know this is probably going to be way too much. God, this stuff is so thick. I figured I would hear in the background something, but I guess she's going to leave that one alone.
Hmm?
Threw you a softball there.
Was that all? That's what she said and I missed it?
Yeah.
Dang it.
That would have been a perfect in the background, like just off in the background.
That's what she did. Great.
Oh god.
That one dulled down real good.
But it poured perfect. Alright, so
these
under. Well, now we know the this one's a little thinner, so we'll just pour that in here. Oh my god, that's way too much.
Yep.
I might have to...
Do you want me to
get some coasters out? Well, we should just do some coasters. Might as well just do a couple anyways. We're gonna need to take them to the art fest.
Might as well start doing them.
Yeah. We will be in an art festival April 6th through the 8th here in beautiful Dallas, Texas. Down in Deep Ellum. That will be next month.
I'll leave the link in the comments. I mean, in the description box to the website so you can get all the information. You're pretty hard to count on that. I'm gonna go back over here then into my hobby hole.
You need to go over there in that hobby hole and do some of that hobby.
I'm about to. In 11 minutes.
Definitely thins out, that's for sure. The heat. And then make sure you don't hit too hard on the side and take your tape off. It's always good to have a rag. Rag that you definitely don't want to use again. Soak it in alcohol so you can kind of wipe your hands off when you get the resin on it. Cleans it right off. Just have it to the side so when you touch your other items, you're not getting it all sticky. Just poured about that much in there. And I'm gonna put I got some on there, but gold never hurt anything. Be sure you always close your lids. Alright, use some white. Sorry, I don't talk as much as
what's her name?
A lot of people do. Or you. You talk constantly. I know, I'm just saying I don't talk, so I'm not used to it. If I do, I'd normally talk to myself. Like when I'm doing art. And like if I'm at the art supply store, I'm sure other people do that as well. I just put a little, because I know this stuff doesn't like acrylic paint that much. It'll turn into marshmallow fluff. But I think my colors have been turning out kind of muddy and a little crazy because I've been using all spray paint. I don't really do that. I don't really use a lot of spray paint, like maybe for a color or two, but not for all the colors, and I've been doing that. We're gonna put that magenta ink, and then this is gonna look amazing on this because it's a white background. Yeah, let's make this like this. And I always like to put a lot of glitter. Whew! That's a lot. But, when is there ever too much glitter? Right? Especially when it has to do with pink. Probably put a little bit more clear in there. I want to put some of this magenta in there. That's the good thing about ink, is that you still be able to see the glitter. If it was like there is some hair in there. Look like it. acrylic or spray paint would just cover up the glitter. You wouldn't even be able to see it, but you could still see that. That's what I love about using the inks. And then when it goes over the opaque stuff, you really see it. So let's do this. Since we have corners, I think I'm just gonna go right in the middle. I'm not gonna use a lot of the gold when I do the dots or the white. We'll just do little parts. And you can always add the gold and white. What did we do? We did a light and a dark. Let's do a dark. Let's do the gold. Or the magenta glitter. And then this. It'll be like reverse. So let's do one right here where it's built the gold. Ooh, that's a lot. I just love the idea of none of this resin coming off right now. So let's do a pour of this right in the center, and then we'll just tilt it. We'll put some heat on it. Tilt it. Let's do one. Let's do a little baby one this white. And watch that gold just pop through there. A little known fact about Erica, she can't whistle. Can you guys whistle? Leave your comments below.
Why you gotta throw me out like that? Just tell
the. Are you guys ready for this?
No.
Oh my God, this stuff is so thick. Wow.
That's what she said.
So you can go all the way to the edges. That's such a weird effect, like, not going anywhere. Let's try to use some fire on this. Here comes that gold. I don't know if you guys can see that. I should have had the light on this. Ooh, boy. There's no light.
That's just gorgeous. It looks a lot like the one I wanted to recreate. You guys, I know you remember this tile that I did and I said I wanted to figure out how to make a piece out of this one. Jeff is basically just one up to my tile. You hit that with some heat and it's gonna sell up like crazy. Okay.
It's so funny that the glitter just flings out when the heat hits it. not sure I like having these edges. Like, it doesn't... I think it's just gonna, like, puddle towards the center. And since this is such a crappy canvas... Look at that. It's all just gonna go right towards the center. Worried. That's fun. I think I want to take this edge. Oh, that looks great right there. Fun. I think I'll leave that. What do you guys think?
I think it's amazing.
Yeah. The sides are holding up.
Your tape held up really well.
Yeah. All right, we'll come see this in like 2 hours. See. All right, so we're gonna take this tape off here. It looks really smooth, real nice. It came through the bottom a little bit on the corners. I think that's just because it was super heavy on the corners. So, let's try this. All right. I don't know. I don't know if it's been a couple hours, but look at this. And see, I wanted it to, I know it's still gonna kind of drip over, which I don't mind. It might be a little more artsy that way. What I'm kind of looking for, or at least hoping for. Oh, you can see that it's doing that. I don't mind that. I kind of wanted it to do that. You could probably wait. I went and got some of these to off. But this is what I love. They're real smooth. Like, the edges are smooth. You can see it's just kind of dripping down. It got through the tape a little bit, but I'm not really mad at that. I'm gonna put these just on the inside. So if it does come off, it doesn't. There. Let's see. If you didn't want him to drip like that, you could probably wait about 2 hours, 3 hours. I think this was just an hour. I guess depending on... Whoops. Sorry about that. Good. I thought it would drip a little bit more, but It's really nice here in Dallas today, so I don't think the... heat temperature is helping it. It's actually helping it cure a little faster, I'm sure. So. But there you go. Taking the tape off an hour later, at least.
All right, you guys, this is how this one turned out. And this is the look that he was going for. He wanted to get it all the way around with this, like, organic kind of ice creamy drip. But it didn't do that all the way around. It kind of ended up leaking here. And so we have an aluminum tape that we're going to use for the next time we try this. But it turned out really level. I think it's a good looking piece overall. What do you guys think?